kind and forgiving and overlooks all the stuff that goes wrong against you, or are you a scorekeeper? Because that's the opposite of being a person of grace. It's a person who keeps score. What you said, what you did, what I remember at one time, way back in 1955. Okay, we got... That's the difference between grace and being a person of non-grace, is you're still keeping score. Oh, well, you did some good things, so I'll erase three, stick man. Oh, you forgot Valentine's Day. Oh, but you did the laundry. But you did it wrong. The point being, allow us to keep score. And it hurts every relationship we have. Every relationship we have. By not being people of grace. We all have a ticket. Everybody's got a ticket. See, people in America, they got this idea that Christian people are the only ones who are going to live forever. Not true. Everybody lives forever. Isn't that good news? Everybody, everywhere, lives forever. The question's where? See, that's the difference. See, but the mentality in America, if you said, who is it that has eternal life? They would say, Christians. No. Everybody has eternal life. Question's where? And so what I'm asking today is the ticket you've been given. Because you were born, somebody breathed life into you, here you go. There's your ticket. We all got a ticket. Does it say London, England, or does it say London, Ontario? Because London's not London unless you know what country it's in. And you say, well, I have eternal life. Yes, you do. But where? There's two options. According to the Bible. According to the Bible, there's two choices. And the really weird part is, you get to choose. We get to pick where to go for vacation. Where do you want to park? Where do you want to stay forever? That's up to you. The thing is that what would be fair is for every one of us to spend our life, eternity in hell, separated from God. That would be fair. Because that's what we've earned. True? Or, am I lying? That's true. That would be fair. But what's not fair is that because of grace, we can spend eternity in the presence of God. That's not fair, but that's what grace is. Because God doesn't keep score. God wants to be gracious. Tickets taken, so. My question to you today, real simple. Do you know where? And if you don't know where, you can take care of that today. It's the strangest thing. You can be driving on 408, and the next thing you know, you're on Dean Road. And all you did was take a little turn. You can be on a life that's being lived for yourself, and you can take a little turn, and now you're on a life that's being lived for God. That fast. Same car, just a different direction. You get to choose. You get to choose whether you want to make that turn. God, in the next 30 seconds, help us to be honest. And help us to be honest with ourselves and be honest with you. To determine if we need to make that adjustment in our lives today. And God, we sit still and we listen for a second. We just listen for what you might say. God, help us to be people of grace. At home and at work. At school. At church. Help us to be people that demonstrate your love and forgiveness. Help us to not keep score. And God, whether we came at the first hour of the day or whether we make it at the 11th hour, thank you, God, for the gift of your grace. That grace that makes all this possible. In Jesus' name.